Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss the continuation of the topic which we did on session 15, which was data store and shared storage. So today we are going to see how to add a new data store and what is VMF file system. For those of you who are joining me now, my name is Ibrahim Qureshi and welcome to my channel. I'm delivering a course VMware tutorial for beginners. Please feel free to subscribe and hit the notification button so that you don't miss out on the next on the sessions which I deliver. I post two sessions every week, so you'll be seeing the content quite regularly, and I'll be updating my blog with the same so that you can follow it. Okay, so let's get started with the agenda. What is data stores? We covered this in the last topic. Why do we need shared data stores? So data stores are where the VMs will be residing, or where the VMs will be running from. And shared storage is basically the same storage is shared among all the hosts, so they are accessible from all the hosts. So we are going to cover these topics. We are going to cover VMFS file system again. Then we are going to dive in and do a live demo on how to add a new data store. So stay tuned for that. Okay, let's get started. How to add a data store. So for adding a data store, obviously you log into your vSphere client and you go to your inventory pane, click configuration tab and click storage in the hardware panel. Well, obviously not such hardware panel really. It's more hardware panel was more so in the old versions. In here, obviously you click on the storage tab, and then from there you can click add storage on the data store, add storage, and then you can select a disk or LAN storage type and click next. Select a device you want to add, give a name, and then obviously you can do that. So this is a reference of the content which I have copied here. It's from docs.vmware.com. You're going to see the live demo, as I said. So just to show you the setup, we have a data store, second one, and a third one. So all these data stores are presented to this host and also this one. So just to give you a little bit of background, okay, so let's go to our very expensive drawing tool, MS Paint here, and quickly show you the information a little bit about how all this glues together with the storage. So let's assume this is a storage unit. So we have one storage processor, another storage processor, and then you have your ESX host. Let's put that gray color. So what actually happens is, this is your storage array. Obviously you'll be having disk here, so these are your hard drives. Assume you have your SAS drives or NL drives or flash drive, whatever, it doesn't matter. Then this will be presented as a logical unit, and it will be sliced accordingly. So it will be sliced when you ask for storage, this will be sliced and given to you. So let's just control that. So obviously if you ask for a 2 terabytes, so that will be probably this bit which will be presented. But underneath, what happens is, obviously this is storage array, it could be EMC array, it has 2 storage processors. Let's call it SP1 and this one is SP2. This basically goes and it's connected to the HBA here and here. Over here we have two HBAs, HBA1 and HBA2, which gets connected from the storage. And then obviously the same applies here. So obviously in theory you have a MDS in the middle where this gets deployed, connected to that, and from there it gets patched to here. So this is the background for it. So let's get quickly into our demo. So as I was saying, these are the hosts which are going to be used. I'll be using 103 today to provision a new LAN. So let's quickly open the browser without wasting any more time. So I have logged into my vCenter, select the ESX host. Now there are a number of ways you can do it. This is the configuration side of it. So when you go configuration, you can select data stores, and then you can see you have it here. Or on that same data store, same host, you can click on data store, and then you have this the same tab here. Click on add new data store. Over here you'll get three options. NFS, as I was saying in my previous session, you can present it with NFS, and we also have virtual volumes, vVols, which VMware call. So that's also available. You can have vVols with pure storage if you use pure, or if you have generic storage also you can use pure storage again, but normally you use VMFS. So you select the first option, select next, you give a name. So I normally try to keep the naming convention same. So let's just give FreeNAS LAN 02, best practices really to keep everything in line with your infrastructure. So select the LAN which you want to present. So I have selected this LAN and then click on next. Now this is the flash drive, I don't want to select that, I want to use the local one. So select next. Now you have option for VMFS 5 and VMFS 6. So with VMFS 6, as I said, VMFS 5 is available to connect to anything 6 or earlier. If you have anything 6 or earlier, make sure you always select VMFS 5. If you don't have 6 or anything earlier, then you can go to VMFS 6. Okay, VMFS is basically, obviously I should have gone a little bit deeper on the slides, but didn't. I wanted to cover this topic as well anyway. So VMFS is VMware file system. So when you add this LAN, the VMware will format it in VMFS file system. You might have heard with Windows, you have NTFS, with Linux, you have LVM, in that you have ext1, ext2, ext3. But for VMware, the file system is VMFS. And if you're using anything below 6, ESX 6, which you shouldn't be really, because it's going to be out of support very soon, you should be using VMFS 5. If you're using 6.5 or 6 or above, then you can use, if you're even using 6 and you don't have anything below 6, use VMFS 6. For now, I'm going to use VMFS 5 because I have to show you a demo of how to upgrade VMFS 5 to VMFS 6, which will be an interesting one. So keep an eye on that in the coming weeks. So you select next. Now over here you can see you can reduce this size. I know it's a 10 GB, but you can reduce this to 5 GB and say next, and you can see immediately it has given 5 GB only. That much how we have selected next, and this is the final configuration, finish. And once you finish, you will see another LAN there. You go, boys. So and again, I'll be doing a couple of sessions on how to upgrade VMFS 6 to VMFS 5 to 6. To be honest, there's no upgrade path from VMFS 5 to VMFS 6. So there's a process you need to follow to decommission the existing LAN of VMFSY and then reformat it and bring it in similarly how we did, but selecting VMFS6. But there are certain rules to follow when you're decommissioning a LAN. We'll go through that in the next session. So this was a quick demo of how to add a data store on ESX 6.7, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Let's quickly go back to my session. So we have done our demo. I advise you to subscribe to me and reach out to me on Twitter at Ibrahim Qureshi if you have any questions. Be sure to check out my blog, which is ibrahimqureshi.com, and also the new one, which is agileops.co.uk. If you have the question of the day is the upgrade process, which I briefly told you. I know it's a bit cheeky. I only told you, I didn't show you. Or leave a comment below on upgrade process if you remember it, guys. And hope to see you guys in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, enjoy watching, and keep sharing. And don't forget to hit the notification button so you don't miss out on my next sessions. Thanks. Bye.